Hi, I'm Josh from eSpares, and in this video, I'll be helping you to diagnose, control, and program issues with your dishwasher. The very first thing we're going to look at is if your dishwasher is completely dead. The first thing to check is whether power is actually getting into the dishwasher. So unplug it from the socket and plug something else in, such as a hairdryer or a vacuum cleaner or anything, just to make sure that there is power at the socket. Now, once you've established that that is the case, we can move on to looking at the plug and making sure that the fuse in the plug hasn't blown. So I'm just going to take the back off the plug of the dishwasher and then grab a multimeter and place that onto the lowest resistance reading. And just have a quick check of the resistance of the leads on your meter just by shorting them together. And on here, I'm getting a reading of about 1.7. So if I just place the probes onto the fuse at either end, I should get a similar reading if the fuse hasn't blown. And again, I'm getting about 1.7. So that shows that the fuse is okay. Now, when you've established that the fuse in the plug is okay, the next thing to do is check for continuity between the plug and the control board in your dishwasher. Now, in this particular dishwasher, the control board is housed at the top on the inside of the door, but it can vary from one model to another. So in yours, it may be at the bottom of the door, or it may be on the side at the back of the dishwasher. So you may have to look around to find it. So I'm just going to start by unscrewing the screws around the inside of the door so I can get to the control board inside. Okay, so here we have the control board inside the door. Now I'm looking for continuity between the plug and the control board. So I'm going to be checking how the power comes down through the live and neutral pins on the plug. It's then going to come possibly through an on-off switch if your dishwasher has one. If it does, make sure the switch is turned on for this, and it then goes from the switch into the control board. Now, the way that I'm going to be testing is looking for a short circuit on the meter. Now, of course, normally a short circuit is a bad thing, but in this case, the short circuit shows that there is a connection between the plug and the board. So I'm going to start by placing one of the probes of the meter onto the live pin of the plug. I'll just close the door here to make it a bit easier. And then grab the other probe of the meter and place that onto the brown pin here. And because I'm looking for a short circuit, it should read round about a couple of ohms, but possibly less. And again, I'm getting about 1.8 there. So now I've established that power is getting from the plug to the control board, but not getting any further. That would probably explain why the dishwasher is dead, and it's because the control board is faulty. Now, if when you do this, you aren't getting a reading on the meter, just try moving the probe on the board around all the different wires until you do get a reading. And of course, when you do get a reading, that would show that the power is getting to the board, but the board is faulty and needs to be replaced. On the other hand, if moving the probe around still doesn't produce any reading, then that would indicate that there is a fault between the plug and the board, and it's most likely to be in the wiring. The next fault we'll have a look at is if your dishwasher is blowing a fuse when you turn it on. Now, in most cases, this is going to be caused by the presence of a short, and that can either be in the control board or in one of the components elsewhere in the dishwasher. In most cases, it's actually going to be in the heater. Now, we can test for a short just by using our meter to test across the live and neutral or live and earth pins on the plug. And again, a short is going to show up as less than a couple of ohms. Now, if you do get the reading of a short circuit, try disconnecting the heater and then testing again on the plug to see if the short is gone. And if the reading is much higher, then that would show that the short circuit is likely to lie in the heater. And you can confirm that by testing the heater itself. For a working heater, the reading should be somewhere between 20 and 50 ohms. So obviously any reading that is significantly outside of those would indicate that the heater has developed a short circuit and you'll need to replace it. Now we've looked at power problems, let's move on to look at program problems and fault codes. The control boards in most dishwashers respond to faults in the appliance with fault codes, and this can be through a combination of lights or letters and numbers. However, manufacturers use different fault codes for their dishwashers, so it can be just as beneficial to watch the dishwasher and see when in a cycle it stops to determine when the fault is occurring. The first point at which you might get a fault code is when you turn the dishwasher on. If water has leaked into it, the dishwasher may register this as a flood, and you'll hear the drain pump whirring continuously as it tries to get rid of that water. Now you can check to see if there's any sort of leakage just by tilting the dishwasher onto its side and watching to see if any water drains out the bottom. If it does, just take the base off the dishwasher and have a look inside at the pipes for any damage. It may also be that the detergent has simply foamed too much and that's caused a leakage. Whatever happens, just get rid of any water or anything in there that's causing it to leak, and then put the base back on and turn the dishwasher on again to see if that resolves the problem. Now, when you've turned your dishwasher on and closed the door to start the cycle, the first thing that happens is the drain pump turns on. Any liquid that's run off the glassware or the crockery into the machine is drained away, and that takes about 20 seconds. After that, the inlet valve turns on and the dishwasher starts to fill with water until it's just below the door seal. Once it's hit the correct level, the wash pump turns on, and that's when you hear that familiar whoosh noise as the water is sprayed around the dishwasher. After that, the heater turns on if required, and shortly after the heater turning on, you'll hear that very familiar clunk noise as the dispenser drawer opens and lets the detergent into the dishwasher. Now, failure to complete any of those parts of the process will result in the dishwasher stopping and displaying a fault code. The rest of the wash cycle consists of washing, draining, and heating, followed by the drying cycle. Now, some dishwashers use a fan in their drying cycle to circulate air around the cavity and help the water evaporate off the crockery, while other dishwashers rely simply on the residual heat within the crockery for the water to evaporate off. Now, one final thing to consider if you need to replace the control board in your dishwasher. Many manufacturers make their control boards so that they have to be programmed when they are fitted. Now, this is possible for you to do, but it may require purchasing additional equipment and this can be expensive. So for that reason, if you are replacing the control board, you may prefer to use a fixed price repair service such as RepairCare, who can do the fix for you. If you need help with diagnosing other faults in your dishwasher, see our other eSpares videos. And spares for dishwashers, along with other appliances, are available on the eSpares website. Thanks for watching.